Unar put up his hand and coughed. The Financial Crime Division are seeing this stuff for the first time now, after these revelations from Panama. Otar was murdered before all this became public knowledge, so we can't be certain that these people knew anything about Otar's involvement. We have confirmation that the media that worked on this with WikiLeaks did contact some of these individuals before going public to seek information from them. So that fits into our time frame. It would have been before Otar was killed, Gardar said. However, we are yet to ascertain whether or not any of the journalists mentioned Otar by name.
Sigurdís was really beginning to wonder whether the investigation was on the right track. If it turned out that Otar's name hadn't been mentioned by any journalists or reporters during their conversations with the former owners of these companies, and Elin, and even Dathi himself, had mentioned several times that Dathi and Otar kept their relationship very well hidden, then why would these people have any motive to go after Otar? In addition, she recalled that most murders are committed by someone close to the victim, and it was rare for business to be a motive. Gardar, she began tentatively, have we ruled out the family connections or the links to America as part of this investigation?
What we have here is the most solid set of leads so far, Sigurdís, so we'll base our work on these. Do you have any reliable leads that point elsewhere?
Sigurdís felt the heat in her cheeks, not because she felt it was right to rule out other options, but because Gardar's reply had been so abrupt. She could sense the irritation among the others too. She would have to take care to keep her feet on the ground if she intended to be taken seriously on this investigation. In reality, she had no solid evidence to tell her the answer lay somewhere other than in these business dealings. Nothing more than Carla's manner on the phone call, Stephen's appearance in Iceland, and her own intuition.